Good afternoon, members of the media. Thanks for coming. The TTFA board met in special session. Don't use the word special session because it was a meeting just called to deal with the whole situation of football in Trinidad and Tobago and the so-called T-League that has been bandied about. It has not been an official league. It's just a name that has been tagged. You know how we operate in Trinidad and Tobago. This is a situation that needed the attention of the Trinidad and Tobago Football Association, because I want to put on record that one, the Super League is not a member of the TTFA, and the Pro League is not a member of the TTFA. All the clubs in the Super League and all the clubs in the Pro League are members of the TTFA. And as president, I felt it very important that we call a meeting to deal with our members and the situation that our members have found themselves in. There has been a lot of stuff bandied in the media, on social media, and so on, as the state of Trinidad and Tobago football. I want to put on record that this president was the one who brought UEFA here to help the professional league. There is no secret that there have been some trials and tribulations amongst the professional football league, as any other league have experienced over their test of time. We see it in Argentina, we see it all over the world, and the TT Pro League is no different. But what I can say about the TT Pro League is that it remains steadfast and committed to the game of football in Trinidad and Tobago. And what I'll also say about the TT Pro League is the fact that the owners have invested a tremendous amount of money in the sport. Regardless of the amount of money that government has invested in the Pro League over the last 8 to 10 years, the TT Pro League owners have invested a tremendous amount of money in football in Trinidad and Tobago. There's also no secret, as president, that the fortunes of the national team has waned as a result of the problem that existed in the TT Pro League. And as a board, we felt that it was very important that the board step in to deal with this situation. And in dealing with this situation, there was a parameter that was set out for the commission to deal with, and the board today felt that the commission did not fulfill its full responsibility insofar as the task that it was set out to do, and the board voted unanimously to disband the commission. The board also voted unanimously to form a committee of five, which comprised of Mr. Selby Brown, Ms. Julia Batiste, Mr. Anthony Moore, Ms. Susan Warwick, and Mr. Colin Partap, to form a committee to investigate the structures and a pathway forward for Trinidad and Tobago football with immediate effect. I also said to the board, and the board concurred with me, that the scope of this committee is very wide and very powerful. I repeat, the scope of this committee was very wide and powerful, and the board agreed with me. And that committee is going to look at, one, the proposal by the TT Pro League, which was proposed to the board of the TTFA, as well as the extension of a second round of the Ascension League. That committee has been tasked with reporting back to the board within 7 days, with a view of getting football played on the field in the shortest possible time, and that is October 4th. I just want to make it categorically clear that is not to be taken by the journalists and social media, because we have a lot of spin doctors in the media, to say that the board is leaning towards October 4th as recommended by the Pro League. That is to say that that date seems an ideal date, as quickly as possible and the best possible date to start the football. Maybe it starts in late September, maybe it starts a little later in October. So I want to make it categorically clear. Okay? Anything I've missed, Ms. Batiste or Selby, please correct me.
No.
Okay. So that's my opening statement. Open to a few questions from the floor, because I have another appointment. And I'm dealing purely with the football in Trinidad and Tobago. and the whole league structure. Let me also say that is the view of the members of the board that it's important that professional football remains, and it's important that the TTFA take the necessary steps to ensure the survival, one, of the professional football, and two, that it helps the national team in its quest, particularly that World Cup qualifying is right around the corner.
President, there's one thing I want to add, adjust. The initial vote, which was successful in disbanding, the decision to disband the commission, was not unanimous. It was 7-4, four abstentions.
And three against.
And three against.
Two against.
Two against.
Two against. Two against. It was 7-4, two against, four abstentions. Okay?
Yes, sir, correct, Chairman.
Thank you very much, Mr. Brown. Questions? I just said to you that the scope of this committee is far and wide. The T-League was never a league per se, okay? I just said clearly it was a body to investigate the pathway forward for football with a view of getting football played as quickly as possible. Might I also add, and I said to you clearly, there was a proposal from the TT Pro League insofar as starting back professional football and inviting the members of the Super League to form a second division. It was discussed in the meeting as well that this is an opportunity that if it is successful, it will create a pathway and an easy transition into that T-League that you want to talk about. No. So you asked if the T-League has been scrapped. Okay? And I said to you that the committee is far, the scope is far, wide, and powerful. And it was discussed in the meeting that if the recommendation is accepted, I don't know if it will be accepted by the committee, it's an opportunity for that transition into the proposed T-League, so to speak, in far as a seamless transition for the following season.
Okay, so Joe, let me try to clear it up for you. What happened is that the concept of the concept of a league that will have all of football, the higher leagues, the Super League, the Pro League, that concept of elite football and promotion and relegation remains, right? So what has happened is that now we are looking for a way forward to get a place where we could put that on our right track. At this point, what was called the T-League under the concept, that has been dissolved in some form, but the concept remains in that now we have said as a board, what we are going to do is that we're going to form a committee from the board of the TTFA, and that committee will now review the structure and whatnot and set up what we think would be the best structure for football, club football in Trinidad and Tobago. So we're looking for a progression still from the zone to the Super League to the Pro League so that we have one seamless thing going right through. So the concept remains in terms of one elite form of football that everybody will move through and move down. If they can't stay up, they come back down. So the concept remains.
Let me just add to what Ms. Batiste is saying as well, is that the TTFA board has now taken charge of its destiny and its members, okay? And its members. And the board has now taken direct responsibility through that committee to ensure that Trinidad football is put on the right path, and that is club football put on the right path, and there is no stuff all over the media and opinions and so on. Whenever we come back to you, it's going to be a very firm decision and a decision for a pathway for Trinidad and Tobago football.
Once again, to you, Sir Joe, the question of the committee, foremost in mind is pathway for football. The Pro League, and other divisions, including what is now the zonal football, so that all clubs interested in going to the highest level of football in Trinidad and Tobago can be attained on a smooth, structured path. And that has come not only at the meeting this morning, but out of the deliberations with UEFA that date back to April 2018, workshop in September 2018, and a visit with all clubs participating and stakeholders that was held in January 2019. Out of that came the recommendation of the board for a commission with a specific mandate given to that commission with deadlines. The first set of deadlines was supposed to have been achieved at March 31st, 2019. The second set at April 30th. When the board requested a status report, what was done was not a report, but a letter from the commission that gave an ultimatum to the TTFA board that, and that's in the last paragraph, if we do not hear from you by August 16 and funds are not made available by August 16, the commission recommends that
the commission be dissolved.
That August 16th has expired. So the board has taken its decision now. What is also fitting is important to note that at the FIFA Congress Paris 2019, June 2019, the new President Gianni has been given a further term of 4 years. At the CONCACAF conference held in Las Vegas in March, the President Victor has been given a term for 4 years. And what is the opportunity given to Trinidad football at this time is to move in sync with those who view the TTFA favorably at both the FIFA and CONCACAF levels. And that's the opportunity that we will embark on.
Mr. Vendors, you spoke about a proposal for the commission to consider the extension. But then anyone can say at this point what singularly the commission is going to have a
universal
extension of the ascension. At this point,
yeah.
What's the footwork in anyone saying
one week? Quickly, they have been tasked with the responsibility, and I repeat my words, of reviewing the structure and recommendation with the intention and mandate that football will be played this year, even at the highest level.
What football?
Whether it is the extension of the Ascension League or the recommendation of the Pro League. I said that in my opening statements. I said that clearly in my opening statements. They have been tasked with that responsibility as well.
Something as important as this restructuring of football, we think it's prudent to have this within 7 days, like for 1 month, full time for four members, and not to include the general council if we
The general what?
The general council, I think they have been EGM.
Mr. Liebert, I just want to tell you that the committee has always also been tasked with the responsibility to meet with the members of the TTFA, who are the TT Pro League clubs, and the members of the Super League clubs, who are members of the TTFA, right? Insofar as getting football started as quickly as possible. They have also been tasked with the responsibility of creating a pathway forward and report back to the TTFA in the shortest possible time. Maybe the pathway may take a little longer, but it's important that we get football playing at the highest level as quickly as possible. And that the committee has been tasked with that responsibility.
Okay, but there are six zones, Super League, Pro League, Council clubs, it's feasible to get feedback from members of all those bodies at that time
frame. Mr. Leibold, let me tell you something. In this country, right? In this country, if we put our minds to do it, we will do it. You understand? And there are so much shenanigans and proposal and counter proposals and opinions and so on. Let me just put on record. It makes no sense in this country to be talking about, for members of our hierarchy, to be talking about professional football is a fallacy, professional football would not work, scrap the professional league, right? You think all those comments coming from people within the circle goes down well in FIFA? Do you think those comments will not put a spoke in our wheel whether we consider funding the Pro League or we consider funding Trinidad and Tobago football? The FIFA Forward Program money belongs to FIFA, which is transferred to the TTFA, right? And anytime they are transferring that money to the TTFA for the benefits of its clubs, they will come with stipulations. And when all this infighting and bacchanal comes, it does not help Trinidad and Tobago football. And I say that without fear of contradiction or anything else. As far as I'm concerned, the TTFA is responsible for the national team. And you know when the national team don't do well? You know who they want to blame? Maybe not the TTFA. They want to blame the president of the TTFA. But I think it's important step that the board of the TTFA has taken a very important step to understand the importance of football at the highest level, whether it's the TT Pro League and the Super League. That is why they have been tasked with the responsibility to, one, investigate the proposal of the TT Pro League, which is well documented because you guys in the journalists, you get it, you get the whole letter. You get the whole letter. So nothing is secret anymore. And two, to adopt the recommend that we play a second round of the Ascension League. And three, a clear pathway forward for Trinidad and Tobago football. Well, I show one and two feasible within 7 days. I'm sure about that.
To Mr. Lively, one of the board, so it may be a little easier for people to get back to the clubs within the zones and the Super League and Pro League in terms of what has been decided in terms of forming a committee. So you have any representation there. It's just that instead of having everybody come to discuss it, it was decided that we would put a 5-man committee who would go and look at the structure and see what is feasible and come back and make a presentation. It is possible, I think. 7 days is tight. All it would mean is that people would be expected to really make themselves available. The people who were selected to be on the committee, no one said no. That they couldn't be, and
they voted unanimously.
And then 7 days came up, no one said that it was going to be difficult to really do.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So, in light of it, what we have to do, I think, is just give it a good go for the benefit of football in Trinidad and Tobago. All of us know at some point that it is important that professional football gets going. To me, it's also important that we stop infighting possible, and that we start to plot a public, more positive way forward. Everything is not going to be the way we like it. And I'm saying that's why the media is there, so to just try and keep a little balance between the whole system. But in keeping the balance, it must, I don't want no lopsidedness in any form. I respect the fact that the media has to do its job, but I also want them to understand that we also need them in order for us to be successful at a lot of things. And so I would ask on behalf of the president and the members that they support us in giving it a good go. 8 months has gone. I have found that within 8 months, there are a lot of people who have been unemployed, players, coaches, whatnot. And I have found ladies in the stadium who sell. Have not been able to make a little money based on it, so we need to get football going. So what we will do in this system, we come together as quickly as possible make whatever recommendations that we take would be in the best interest of Trinidad Tobago football. I always say that is my goal. If it's not that, I will be sitting here and we make a move forward. So everybody's represented on board in terms of the team. So hopefully, keeping our fingers crossed, it can be done in the shortest possible time.
And let me just also say, the pathway is already there, you know. But a lot of people wasn't respecting the pathway. Because we have the pathway was always from the zones, champion of champions, move to the Super League. Okay? Right? From the Super League. The problem is that we always had a closed league, which is the TT Pro League. There's no secret about that. And I guess it was because of the simple fact that people were trying to protect their investments. Okay, fine. We understand that the MLS is a closed league, but they're a very closed league. Maybe there'll come the time where the MLS may go into promotion or relegation, right? We have run up the TTFA, through the Pro League, has run a closed league. We have seen it fit that we need to go to promotion and relegation. In any case, there's always a decision not to have any demotion in the first year. That was always on the table and that was always agreed upon. So now we have an opportunity. It's not a little bit of tweaking to be done, you know. It's just a little bit of tweaking to be done. And the TTFA has decided that we need to play football for the benefit of our national team as quickly as possible. And the two responsibilities that this committee has, and I again say it's broad, wide, and powerful, is three things. One, to consider the proposal by the Super League clubs and the Ascension League about running a second round. Two, to consider the proposal of the TT Pro League in what has been outlined in days starting the football and having a second division, which can mean a seamless transition into the Elite Football League. And three, a clear pathway forward for Trinidad and Tobago club football. So it's threefold. And I think two of the three can be achieved within 7 days.
We have time for just one more question. I would suggest that you are ready for the committee. Yes, mentioned the last three champions in Cody Gala participated as the organization. I think it's that the board decides to continue as a champion. What is the motion on the three clubs to give them their
That is a position for the clubs to take, not the TTFA president or its board. Because it was an invitational tournament, right? And as far as I'm aware, these clubs chose not to take part. That is a question that you need to ask those three clubs and not the TTFA president.
Right. What aspects of the mention that the board is not satisfied with the commission? What aspects
I could just make one. I'll just read one article for you. There's a document here, right? But I'll just read one article for you, right? Player contracts, right? The commission must decide on the terms and conditions of a considered league player contract. The response to that was no recommendation or report or conditions of player contracts were made or communicated to the TTFA. There are several. I just make one.
So was that the time that you considered these times?
You're not going to put words in this president's mouth for me to get licks on social media. I just said clearly, you're not going to put words in this president's mouth. The board took a decision and we have to accept that decision. And you're not going to ask me as president of the TTFA to make a personal pronouncement on that decision. It was a board decision and not the decision of the TTFA president.
There's no technical member on this 5% commission that are oversight.
Pardon me?
There's nobody with any technical expertise, the past player, the past coach at a particular level on this commission that will decide the structure of the board.
I repeat. The commission powers, the new commission, if you want to call it that, is broad, far, wide, and powerful. and I leave it at that. Right? I leave it at that. Mr. Liebert, I know you will go and spin it on social media, okay? Because there are plenty of people in this room who depends on hits to sell. And I make no apologies for saying that too. The commission or the committee position is broad, wide and powerful. And I repeated that several times, and my colleagues in the room,
it doesn't answer my question.
If they see it necessary to co-opt somebody, so be it.
And if you talk about the program money that I mentioned before, you said that when you get invited, and so it might have affected in some way. Could you explain if the forward money never came from?
No FIFA forward money has been received by the TTFA. No FIFA forward money. We do not sign the check. I could also tell you the application has been made. And look, the general secretary sitting down next to you. The application has been made.
All right,
the Ascension League is an invitational tournament. Okay, right. If you look at the Ascension League, there are clubs that are not even members of the TTFA. So I am sure the committee is going to look at that. There are several teams that are not part of the Super League or the Pro League playing in the Ascension League. It was an invitational tournament which the TTFA has sanctioned for one round, right? There is a committee who has been tasked with that responsibility. So do not ask the president of the TTFA to make a pronouncement on that. You're asking me now to dictate to the committee that has been set up for the TTFA to play a greater role. So don't put words in the president's mouth. There's a committee to deal with that, right? And if they see it fit, they will report back to the board and a decision will be made.
All right, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you.